Okay, one of the questions I get more often than anything else is, what lab values do I need to know for NCLEX? Okay, so I'm going to tell you exactly what lab values you need to know, and I'm going to give you basic normal ranges for that. These lab values that you need to know come directly from the NCSBN website for educators, for NCLEX educators, and the NCSBN is actually the company that writes the NCLEX. So if you know these lab values that I'm going to tell you, you're going to be just fine for NCLEX. Now, before we get started, I have to tell you something incredibly important. The NCLEX is not going to give you a potassium of 5.6 and ask you, or 5.1 and ask you, is that normal? Okay, basically what I'm trying to say is they're going to give you lab values that are far out of the normal range and just make sure that you can identify what the basic normal range is. The reason for that is every hospital has different values, and so it's important that you understand what basic normal ranges are. Okay, for ABG, you need to know pH, CO2, and bicarb. Okay, normal pH is going to be 7.35, 7.45. CO2, 35 to 45. Bicarb, 22 to 26. Those are the lab values I want you to know. Okay? For BUN, the number that you need to know is going to be 5 to 20. Okay, that can vary, of course, by institution, but that's the number I want you to know. For cholesterol, we want our total cholesterol to be less than 200. Greater than that, it's going to be a problem for NCLEX, okay? Glucose, the number you basically need to know is going to be about 70 to 100, with like greater than 120 being diabetic, and you know, less than 60 or so being hypoglycemic. For hematocrit, for females, the number I want you to know is 36 to 46. For males, the number I want you to know is 42 to 52. Okay? Now for hemoglobin, for females, 12 to 15, and for males, 14 to 17. For hemoglobin A1c, for our glycosylated hemoglobin, we're looking at about 4 to 6%. And we really want it to be less than 7%. Greater than 7% is going to be diabetic, is a bit out of control. Okay, so that's really the number I want you to know there. For our platelets, we're going to look about 200,000 to about 400 or 450,000. And anything less than 20,000 is really going to be a huge concern. So less than 20,000, you need to be setting off alarms in your head for your patient, okay? So that's really kind of the number I want you to know. So thrombocytopenia is going to be less than 200,000 with a huge concern less than 20,000. All right. Now, for potassium, you're going to get a question about potassium. I can just kind of guarantee you that. Potassium is something that they really like to ask you. It's going to be 3.5 to 5. The result of low potassium and high potassium is going to be ventricular arrhythmias. Okay, and you're going to get a question about this on your NCLEX. It's just definitely guaranteed. For sodium, 135 to 145. Okay, for our white blood cells, the number I'd like you to know is going to be about 5,000 to 10,000. The question you're most likely going to get on this is going to be like a leukemic patient. You know, that they're going to have low WBCs. Okay, and I don't think you're going to get one about elevated white blood cell count, but of course that indicates infection. Okay, for creatinine, the number I would like you to know is going to be 0.6 to 1.2. Okay, for our PT, PTT, APTT, INR, basically what you're going to get here is going to be a question about if they're on Coumadin therapy, most likely. Okay, so for a patient who is on Coumadin therapy, you want their PT, or their INR, excuse me, to be 2 to 3, okay, for Coumadin. Okay, now if they're not on Coumadin, so maybe you'll get a question about that, you're going to be like 0.8 to 1.2, but most likely your question is going to be on Coumadin. Now with our PTT, we're looking at like 25 to 35 seconds not on therapy, with it being 2 times normal on therapy. Okay, so you might get a question of like, you have a patient who's on Coumadin therapy, they have a PT of 70, what are you going to do? Well, 70 is about 2 times greater than 35 seconds, so we're okay with that. All right, so that's most likely the question you're going to get on that. Now, you guys, these are the values you need to know. So watch this video again, subscribe. We won't get into each of these individually in this video. That's something for a different time. But these are the values. These are the numbers you need. You have to know for the NCLEX, okay? So study these numbers, study these values. And again, I'm telling you, they're not going to give you like a hemoglobin of 16 for a female and ask you if that's normal or not. What they're going to do is they're going to say a hemoglobin of 47 or a hemoglobin of 2. And just make sure that you can recognize what the normal range is. All right, guys? So subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for checking us out, and have a great day.